Here, then, is the shameful secret of my own imperfect nerdity. I hate math. Not conceptually. Conceptually, I love the idea of numbers, the purest expression of logic and reason. I'm just not good at it. At all. Sadly, this means that actually getting into Dungeons & Dragons has always eluded me. I mean, immersive fantasy stories expressed as mathematical equations? How much more nerd can you get, right? But alas, it always remains just out of my reach. Thus, I've had to go on admiring D&D from the outside, like a poor street urchin lingering outside the toy store window, or an internet film critic perched like a ninja in the branches outside Natalie Portman's bedroom window. Which hasn't exactly been a cakewalk, folks. As you're about to see, Dungeons & Dragons has had a rough transition into the world of, say, movies. Now, part of that was just timing. The 1980s saw an explosion of swords and sorcery on TV and movies and video games, but lacking a specific story of its own made D&D a tough sell to the studios, who were incredulous at building a movie around a game or a toy. Imagine that. Instead, it sat on the margins, referenced in everything from E.T. to the third Nightmare on Elm Street movie to the low-budget horror flick Dungeon Master. The closest anyone got was in 1984, when the producers of Krull considered retitling it Dungeons & Dragons the Movie. They didn't. By default, the 80s probably also saw D&D's thus far most successful translation, though Lord knows that's not saying much, in the form of a Saturday morning cartoon. It had all the usual problems of 80s animation, cheesy moralizing, formula plotting, and a strict prohibition on violence, but today it's regarded for some above-average scripts and some clever self-parody at the expense of RPG cliches. The heroes, a bunch of modern kids transported into the D&D realm, have character classes the opposite of their own personalities. The all-American leader guy is a ranger, the coward is a cavalier, the good girl was the thief, the little kid was a barbarian, the science nerd was a magician, and the, acrobat was, well, diversity is a nice thing. In the early 2000s, to capitalize on the impending fantasy boom expected to follow Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter, director Sandy Kalra finally gave the world an official Dungeons & Dragons movie. The results weren't pretty. Featuring atrocious effects and a villain with purple lipstick, it's today best remembered for a hilariously over-the-top turn by Jeremy Irons. It was a box office bomb and despised by fans, but a decade or so later, they actually did make a sequel. For the Sci-Fi Channel, so you know it's good. But neither of those works can stand as the gravest cinematic crime against Mr. Gygax's baby. That distinction belongs to Tom Hanks. Some background. In the late 1970s and early 1980s, D&D got embroiled in a controversy that eerily presaged the later witch hunts against heavy metal and video games. There was even a whole anti-D&D lobby called, I kid you not, Bothered About Dungeons & Dragons, or BADD. An otherwise unrelated set of teenage deaths and suicides were found to be linked by the coincidence that some involved liked to play RPGs. The media exploited the hell out of this non-story, and soon the usual gang of reactionary idiots were stirring up the unwashed masses about games promoting Satanism and yada yada yada. In 1981, the controversy inspired a crappy Rona Jaffe potboiler cleverly titled Mazes and Monsters, which was made into an infamously terrible TV movie starring a young Tom Hanks, as a troubled college student who suffers a psychotic breakdown after getting into RPGs with his friends. He winds up wandering New York, attacking people he thinks are monsters from the game. It's like if someone let Jack Thompson write and direct The Wizard, though it must be said there's nothing quite like a future two-time Oscar winner wandering around alleys and subways blabbing about his bag of spells. Most recently, Dungeons & Dragons turned up as the framing device of Bender's Game, which for my money was the best of the overall underappreciated Futurama movies. Additionally, one of Hollywood's biggest D&D fans, Vin Diesel, no, really, has worked hard to insert references to game minutiae like Elementals into his Riddick movie, which, for some reason, we're getting another one of. But other than that, there's been no new move to bring the franchise back to the screen on the horizon. And frankly, that just strikes me as lazy. Tim Burton is doing a Monsterpocalypse movie. Peter Berg is doing Battleship. Are you telling me I'm gonna see a freaking World of Warcraft movie before a proper Dungeons & Dragons movie? 'Cause that's just wrong. See you next time.